Today we will be discussing Robert Hooke and his contributions to Enlightenment thinking in the 17th century. Robert Hooke was born July 18, 1635, on the Isle of Wight. He was educated by his father growing up and attended Westminster School at age 13. He then attended Oxford University afterwards. He came into contact with many Enlightenment thinkers, including chemist Robert Boyle, with whom Hooke served as an assistant to. Robert Hooke was a virtuoso during his lifetime, meaning he was accomplished in multiple fields of science, including physics, astronomy, chemistry, biology, geology, architecture, and naval technology. Additionally, Hooke was an inventor, making such things as the iris diaphragm, an early prototype of the respirator, and the universal joint, which is used in cars today. He also theorized the popular physics equation describing elasticity that is still used today and is known as Hooke's law. Other things Hooke was involved with included the newly formed Royal Society of London, of which he was the curator for experiments. His duty was to come weekly with a new experiment he designed.
Micrographia was the result of Hooke creating his compound microscope and illumination system with a pencil and paper at his side. He used both of these inventions to see the details of the smaller world around us. Hooke began observing multiple organisms, including insects, sponges, bryozoans, foraminifera, and bird feathers. One of his more notable drawings included the flea, which Hooke described as adorned with a curiously polished suit of sable armor, neatly joined. The picture shown is what the foldout looked like inside the book. Furthermore, the book was rather large, so the pictures that Hooke created were big, accurate, and detailed. Hooke was the first scientist to examine fossils under the microscope and the first to note the similarities between living shells and fossil shells, which had up to that time been considered a type of stone rather than a once living organism. More than 200 years before Darwin, Hooke had discovered that changes in life on Earth were documented in the fossil record. Another famous drawing that Micrographia included was thin slices of cork. Hooke discovered plant cells or cell walls in cork tissue. Hooke coined the term cells from the cells in a monastery. Hooke also had a drawing of a limited area of the moon's surface. The crater known as Hipparchus, which Hooke recreated with fantastic accuracy, besting the limits of his time in early cartography. Hooke's book was the bestseller of its day. He received much fame from the book and drawings, which still continues to be a wonder to us in the 21st century.
Instead of looking outwards towards new continents and unexplored territories like many of the scientific minds of that day, Hooke looked inwards towards the unexplored territories of the microscopic world. Through his drawings, he exposed things and ideas never seen before to not just the reading public, but to the general public. By including these incredibly detailed and beautifully drawn illustrations, Hooke also uniquely blended the arts with science in ways not often seen before. What also made Micrographia unique was that, unlike Sir Isaac Newton's works, the Principia, other scientific works of that day, an individual didn't need to read Latin or understand complex mathematics to understand the significance of the book. Individuals could simply look at the pictures and discover a new way of looking at the world. In addition to this, through his meticulous attention to detail and his use of the microscope, Hooke emphasized empirical-based science and the use of instruments in scientific studies. It emphasized experimental science that involved detailed observations and cataloging those observations in an organized and detailed manner. Hooke's works not only greatly impacted the Enlightenment, but also continues to impact the world today. The fascination with the microscopic world that Hooke began is still blatantly present in science today. Since the invention of the microscope and the publishing of Micrographia, scientists continually strive to discover what this world is made of, and have even gone so far as to discover the subatomic particles that make up the proton. The fascination of sharing with the world what can be seen under a microscope has also continued. In fact, Nikon hosts an annual competition called the Small World Photomicrography Competition, in which contestants use various types of microscopes to capture the beauty of the microscopic world. The pictures on screen now are both of a common housefly under a simple compound microscope. The one you see on the left is from Hooke's Micrographia, while the one on the right is the 2005 winner of the Nikon Small World Competition. This shows the continued blending of art and science that Hooke used in his groundbreaking book, Micrographia, and the desire to capture the microscopic world in perfect detail. Robert Hooke was an extraordinary scientist whose contributions in multiple fields impacted Enlightenment thinking. His works continue to have a significant impact in our world today.